Hello friends, I'm from New Era Education Hub. Today I'm with you with a new video lecture on the same series, that is conic sections, and but with a new topic, that is the different form of equations of circles. In the previous lecture I've taught you about the locus of a point, which was not generally specific to circles but was basically general to all coordinate geometry. But in today's lecture I will come specific to the circles, that is different form of equations of circles. Let's start with it. What basically we know about circles is its distance from a specific point. We join all the points that are at specific distance from a specific point. We will basically use the previous lectures, that is the locus, and this property, that constraint, which we have talked about it in locus. हम locus में जो हमने बात की थी, हम उसका use करके हम आज equations prove derive करेंगे किसकी, circle की. Let's see. देखिए पहला एक circle मान लीजिए coordinate plane में, जिसका radius क्या है R, और कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या हैं सेंटर के, ए कॉमा बी. अब बेसिकली मैंने कहा व्हाट आई जस्ट सेड अबाउट द लोकस इज दैट इट इज बेसिकली द इक्वेशन ऑफ द पाथ व्हिच अ पॉइंट ट्रेसेस अंडर सम कॉन्स्ट्रेंट. एंड व्हाट बेसिकली अ कॉन्स्ट्रेंट ऑन अ सर्कल इज दैट इट इज एट अ स्पेसिफिक डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम अ स्पेसिफिक पॉइंट. सो लेट्स टेक अ पॉइंट x कॉमा y, एंड नाउ how we will basically derive the equation of a circle is by putting a constraint on point x comma y, that its distance from a comma b will always remain equal to r, and you know this constraint is of circle, so you know that x comma y point will have a locus of a circle. But by putting this constraint you will get an equation which you know will be the equation of a circle. So by this you will get an equation of a circle with center a comma b and radius r. So let's start. By distance formula you can see that the distance between x comma y and a comma b is under root of x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square. And what is the basic constraint? That distance between these two points always remain equal to r. So basically the distance formula gives us this. Squaring both sides we will get, so basically this is the first equation which we need. In it the center is, you know that the center is a comma b, and the radius is r. Okay, x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to r square. This is basically the first form of equation which we need, and you should remember this, that this is the basic form in which a comma b is a center and radius is r, and we write it as x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to r square. So how we have derived this equation is by using of distance relation. We used distance relation to find this formula. Do remember that. Maybe you may need this somewhere. Now let's talk about the second equation, that is the general equation, about the general equation of circle. Basically before telling you the general equation of circle, I will be telling you the general equation of a conic section. What basically the general equation, the specific term, the general equation means? I am telling you that the general equation of circle. What does that mean? That means if we write this general equation of circle, this can represent any equation, any circle. This can represent any circle that is in a plane, any circle. So what basically, first I will tell you that basically you know that the circle is a part of a conic section. So basically I will tell you about the general equation of a conic section, that is some equation I will tell you, and then we'll tell you the specifics that you need to, that change, specific changes that you need to make the in general equation of conic section to make it a specific equation of general equation of circles. देखिए circles, parabola, hyperbola, ellipse, conic sections हैं. अगर हमारे पास एक equation है जो इन सब को represent कर सकती है एक पूरे plane में, तो अब हम अगर उसमें कुछ specific changes ला दें ताकि वो family of circles की equation बन जाए, family of हर family of circles, मतलब हर circle भी वो represent कर सके, तो उसकी अगर वो equation बन जाए तो वो हमें कुछ उसमें changes करने पड़ेंगे. तो पहले हम देखिए general equation of conic section की बात करते हैं. That is ax square plus by square plus 2hxy plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. This is basically the general equation of a conic section in which variables are a, b, h, g, f and c. Varying this a, b, h, g, f and c, we will get different types of conic sections. That is, we can get parabola, ellipse, hyperbola or ellipse depending on how a, b, h, g, f, c have the relation. Okay, so what now I will discuss about what specific changes you have to make in this equation to be sure that this equation, to be sure that this equation represents the equation of circle. Let's start. First point that you should remember for this equation to be a circle. ये equation कोई भी चीज represent कर सकती है, circle, parabola, hyperbola और ellipse. पर हम बताएंगे कि इसको circle का represent करने के लिए इसमें क्या होना चाहिए. इसमें basically जब a is equal to b कह लो, और coefficient of x square is equal to y square. ये एक चीज जरूरी है इस इक्वेशन को सर्कल रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए. एंड सेकंड चीज क्या इंपॉर्टेंट है, h इज इक्वल टू जीरो और एक्स वाई टर्म इज नॉट प्रेजेंट, इज नॉट प्रेजेंट. दिस इज द सेकंड इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन इन दिस. ओके, सो दीज आर द बेसिकली टू स्पेसिफिक कंडीशंस दैट यू नीड टू मेक इन दिस. अगर ये चीजें इस पे हम अप्लाई कर दें तो वो चीज इसकी क्वेश्चन, वो चीज सर्कल की क्वेश्चन रिप्रेजेंट करेगा. अब ये चीजें हम इसमें अप्लाई करके देखते हैं कि जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ सर्कल क्या आती है. a इज इक्वल टू बी, मतलब a इज इक्वल टू बी कर दीजिए, और a इज इक्वल टू बी करके अगर हम पूरे को a से डिवाइड करेंगे तो हम नए कोफिशियंट, नए वो कोफिशियंट आ सकते हैं एक्स वाई के. तो हम ऐसा करते हैं, वन वन ले आते हैं एक्स स्क्वायर और वाई स्क्वायर की जगह, एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर प्लस 2h xy. h क्या है, 0 है, तो ये वाली टर्म पूरी खत्म हो जाएगी. ओके, क्योंकि h 0 है, xy टर्म नहीं प्रेजेंट होनी चाहिए. और प्लस 2gx प्लस 2fy प्लस c इज इक्वल टू 0. सो बेसिकली जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ कॉनिक सेक्शन इज दिस विच कैन रिप्रेजेंट एनी थिंग, दैट इज सर्कल, पैराबोला, हाइपरबोला, एलिप्स, एंड इवन इट कैन रिप्रेजेंट स्ट्रेट लाइंस. And pair of it, even this can represent pair of straight lines. Do remember that this can even represent the pair of straight lines. Okay, so for this equation to represent specifically the circle part, we will have to follow these two conditions, and following these two conditions and implementing in this equation, we will get this specific equation, which is the equation of, which is the general equation of circle. Basically this is the general equation of circle. Okay, so now I will tell you that if how to find the radius and the center coordinates from this general equation. Let's see. See, this is basically the equation, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. What I say you is that x square plus 2gx, add g square and minus subtract g square. Similarly, plus y square plus 2fy, add y square, add f square and subtract f square. So that equation does not change. Add and subtract both. Okay. plus c is equal to 0. So c basically these three forms perfect square, and these three forms perfect square. So x plus g whole square plus y plus g whole square, y plus f whole square minus g square minus f square plus c is equal to 0. Taking these three terms at this side, what we will get? X plus x minus minus g whole square plus y minus minus f whole square is equal to g square plus f square under root g square plus f square minus c and square. Okay, we can write this. Basically we have taken these three terms there. What will that be? G square plus f square minus c. What I have just written, that under root, taking under root and squaring the term, the basic total does not change. Okay, so and here also minus minus is equal to plus, so here it doesn't change. Now comparing this equation with the first equation, x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to r square, what we will get is, what was the center of that circle, a comma b, x minus a y minus b, and what was the center is a comma b. So what will be the center of this general equation? That is minus g comma minus f by comparing. And what will be the radius? X minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to r square. And what will be the radius? Under root g square plus f square minus c will be the radius of the circle. Okay, so let's, now these are the basic two equations. This is the general equation, how to find the rate center and radius from this general equation. We have proved these two formulas. Here is the proof. The first equation, x minus a whole square plus y minus b whole square is equal to r square. These two equations you need to remember. Now we will discuss about some specific forms, some specific family of circles and their equations, and their general equations. Let's see. The first family of circle I am talking about is the circle which passes through the origin. First general equation of circles which I am talking about is the circle which are passing through the origin. And there is not just one circle that can pass through origin. There are infinite, see. There are infinite circles. And now we have to try to find the equation of all these circles generally, like the general equation of circle, you are known, the general equation of that circle. What that general equation of circle represents? All the circles in the plane. And now we have to try to find the general equation of the circles which passes through the origin. Let's just take one case. Now we know that any circle in a plane can be represented by this equation. Okay, any circle can be represented by this equation. Now we have to do some changes to make sure that this equation of circle passes through the origin. Origin have coordinates is equal to 0, 0. So if this circle passes through 0, 0, this equation should satisfy 0, 0. Let's just satisfy that. Here 0 comes, 0, 0, 0. Here c, so c will be equal to 0. So basically a circle to pass through origin having general equation, this its c should be 0. If c is equal to 0, then that general equation will represent this, all the circles that passes through origin. So basic general equation of circles that pass through origin is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy, c is 0. So this is the basic general equation of all the circles passing through origin. Basically you don't have to remember these equations, these are just to build up your logic. as to how to solve the questions, how to perceive a question. Okay. So the second part I will tell you is the general equation of circles which touches x-axis. General equation of circles which touches x-axis. Basically, there are infinite types of circles which touches x-axis of varying radiuses and varying centers. So let's suppose any h comma k be the center of h comma k be the variables, and let's suppose h comma k be the center of a circle touching the x-axis. H comma k variable, why? Because h comma k will vary and will come here, will come there, so it will be, can represent infinite circles. Okay, we cannot fix its center. So h comma k variable, and let it be the center. Now we know that it just touches, this circle just touches the x-axis. What does that mean? This means that the x-axis is the tangent, and you know that the property that radius drawn at the point of tangency is perpendicular to the tangent. Okay, this is the property of 9th and 10th. If you don't remember, just remember that at the point of tangency, agar hum ek radius throw kare, to wo perpendicular hota hai tangent se. To isi formula se hum dekh sakte hain ki h comma k agar ye coordinates se, to iska kya matlab hai? Ye value kya hoti hai h, aur ye value kya hoti hai k. Ab dekhiye, hum ek ye kya hai, ye kya hai r. तो हमें ये देखने को मिल रहा है कि k की अगर ये परपेंडिकुलर है इसके, तो ये क्या होगा? पैरेलल होगा y एक्सिस के. तो r की वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगी? k हो जाएगी. तो बेसिकली हम जो इक्वेशन लिखते हैं x माइनस a होल स्क्वायर प्लस y माइनस b होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू r स्क्वायर, उसमें a की जगह h आ जाएगा, प्लस y माइनस k, b की जगह k आ जाएगा, r की जगह क्या आ जाएगा? k. तो k square, इसको ये क्या आ गई हमारे पास? Equation of all the circles that pass, that touches the x-axis in which h comma k are variable to represent different circles. Okay? तो ये क्या मिल गई हमें? Family of circles. Do remember that family of circles मिली है. हर एक family of circles क्या होता है? Collection of the circles that have some specific property. Whenever we talk about family always have some relation. So when I talk about family of circles, what does that family of circles means? All the pairs of circles that have some specific property. Here, which family of circles we are talking about? Which touches the x-axis? Unki equation kya hai? Ye. Okay? So isko agar hum expand karenge, to aapko kya mil jayegi? General equation. General equation mil jayegi. Similarly, aap y-axis ka bhi kar sakte hain. Aapko kuch nahi karna hoga basically. ये आपको मैंने x का करा दिया, y का आप खुद कर सकते हैं. अब बस आपको मैं हिंट दे देता हूँ, ये देखिए, ये आपको y एक्सिस टच करता हुआ, तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? जब हम इसको अगर हम h कॉमा k मानेंगे, तो ये चीज क्या हो जाएगी? h, ये क्या हो जाएगी? k. तो बेसिकली h, रेडियस h के इक्वल हो जाएगा. इस बार k के नहीं, रेडियस किसके इक्वल हो जाएगा? h के. तो बेसिकली हमें इधर h स्क्वायर डालना पड़ेगा, बाकी a की जगह h, b की जगह k वही रहेगा. ओके, आप देख लीजिएगा एक बार खुद भी. अब हम लास्ट चीज के बारे में बात करेंगे, जो कि है, हम बताएंगे कि एक इक्वेशन क्या होती है. सर्कल, इक्वेशन ऑफ सर्कल विद डायमेट्रिक ऑपोजिट एंड्स टू बी एक्स कॉमा वाई. दिस इज नॉट अबाउट द फैमिली ऑफ सर्कल्स, दिस इज द इंडिविजुअल पार्ट. इक्वेशन ऑफ सर्कल विद diametric opposite ends, this is the diameter because radius center is there. So with diametric opposite ends to be x2 comma y2 and x1 comma y1. Ab hame is circle ki equation nikalni hai. So let's see how we will find out the equation. Basically what I will do is I will give you the equation of this circle and will prove you that basically what these two points lie on the circle, and third, the center is मिडवे है, इन दोनों पॉइंट्स के मिडवे है, तो सेक्शन फॉर्मूला से क्या होगा? इसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या होंगे? x1 plus x2 by 2 y1, ये तो आपने पढ़ा ही होगा 9th 10th में. तो ये सेक्शन फॉर्मूला से ये क्या आ गए? सेंटर के कोऑर्डिनेट्स. तो बेसिकली अगर हम ये तीन चीजें प्रूव कर दें कि ये दो पॉइंट्स उस इक्वेशन पे लाई करते हैं और उसको इक्वेशन को सेटिस्फाई करते हैं, और उसका सेंटर, उस सर्कल की इक्वेशन का सेंटर अगर ये कोऑर्डिनेट्स हैं, तो हम प्रूव कर देंगे कि ये जो सर वो जो इक्वेशन हम लिखेंगे अभी, मैं आपको डायरेक्ट इक्वेशन दूंगा इसकी, तो अगर वो जो हम इक्वेशन लिखेंगे वो इस सर्कल को ही रिप्रेजेंट करती है। तो अब याद रखिए, एक सर्कल जिसके डायमेट्रिक ऑपोजिट एंड एक्स वन कॉमा वाई वन एंड एक्स टू कॉमा वाई टू है, उसकी इक्वेशन है x माइनस एक्स वन इंटू एक्स माइनस एक्स टू प्लस वाई माइनस वाई वन इंटू वाई माइनस वाई टू इज इक्वल टू जीरो। सो अब देख लीजिए, इसमें x1 कॉमा वाई वन डालते हैं, x1 इसमें डालेंगे x की जगह तो ये जीरो हो जाएगा, और y1 डालेंगे तो ये जीरो हो जाएगा। तो बेसिकली x1 कॉमा y1 सेटिस्फाई कर रहा है। सिमिलरली अगर हम x2 कॉमा y2 डालेंगे तो इसमें हम x2 डालेंगे और y2 डालेंगे तो y2 y2 जीरो हो जाएगा, ये बेसिकली टोटल जीरो, ये भी टोटल जीरो। तो बेसिकली ये दोनों पहले पॉइंट सेटिस्फाई कर रहे हैं। अब बेसिकली लास्ट चीज क्या रह गई, हमें ये प्रूफ करना है कि जब हम इसको एक्सपेंड करेंगे और उससे हम इसके कोऑर्डिनेट्स निकालेंगे सेंटर के, क्या निकालेंगे सेंटर के कोऑर्डिनेट्स निकालेंगे, तो वो इससे मैच करने चाहिए। आप देखिएगा, आप घर पे कीजिएगा इसको एक्सपेंड करके, जो जनरल इक्वेशन आएगी उसमें मैंने आपको बताया था कि माइनस जी कॉमा माइनस एफ आर द सेंटर ऑफ दैट सर्कल, आप उन दोनों को इससे मैच करके देखिएगा, दोनों सेम आएंगे, तो हेंस दैट विल प्रूव दैट दिस इक्वेशन इज स्पेसिफिक टू दिस सर्कल। So that's all for this video. Thank you. Do watch all our videos.